Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about TensorFlow Lite and how to take your model and convert it into TensorFlow Lite model, and also I'm going to show a little demo on it, how it works in practice. So first off, we look into this little file here. We have this training that we had before with TensorFlow data, and I haven't changed that much in this file, but I wanted to highlight one thing that is changed here. I've actually added an extra layer, and I also added a dropout layer down here. So one convolution more and a dropout, because how much I ever trained this model, I didn't get it better than 74%, but with an extra convolutional layer and a dropout layer, I got it out up to 84%. And I think I need a little bit to actually be able to predict things. And I also added some identities here. So I have an output prediction, an output class, and this I will not use. I just added some extra to know which things in my model was which, so I can actually access them when I convert later on. So output prediction is important, and I also at the start here set an identifier for the input tensor, so I actually know where my input data comes and where my predictions comes out. And I ran this for I think 4 or 5 hours, so an afternoon, and I got it up to 84% somewhere there. It was actually up at 84 very early. So I have added some extra text here into the TensorFlow data repository, so you can look there if you like to see how to change your graph. So first off, when you have trying to convert a TensorFlow Lite model and you have just trained a model, so you have a directory with your model in it, you need to freeze it so it actually has a specific point in time that you have saved. If you are using the saved model, you can use that right off the bat and convert that. But if you are training a model and it just does an output to a folder, then you need to freeze it first. So you run this command. So I have my input graph here. I have a specific checkpoint that I want to freeze my graph at. I say, as this is PB text up here, then I say that it's not binary, so that's false. I have an output graph, so that's the frozen graph that I put out. And here we have my output node names. And this is actually wrong, because we said that we had input tensor and output pred. So that's the actual node names in your graph that you are interested in. So you are giving the command freeze graph some information about which names you really need to keep in your graph, so when it freezes it, it doesn't remove those names. And then you need a command called Toco. It's the TensorFlow Lite optimizing converter. And it is available in the pip package when you install it, but I was not able to run it from there. It just gave me an error that it wasn't available in the pip package yet. So I had to build it with Bazel, and that works fine on any Linux machine. So everything here, FreezeGraph and so on, I had to actually run my model in Windows, then give it to my little virtual box and convert it in there, and then put it back into my development environment again. So that was a little bit of a hassle back and forth. And then we have this command down here. When we run Toco, we say where our input file is. We tell it that this, in this case, it's a TensorFlow graph def, and we can also tell it that it's a TensorFlow saved model, for instance, if we just save a model. So you can look into that. There's a lot of different parameters that you can put into this. And the output format should be a TensorFlow Lite model, and we say where this TensorFlow Lite model should be at. So this is cats and dogs TensorFlow Lite. And then we have my input here. It's not reshape, it's input tensor. So that's my input arrays. And then output pred in my case, that's my output arrays. And the input shape, this is the size of my image. So it's 224 times 224 and three colors. And this one up here is just so you get the matrix correct. And so that's pretty much it. And then I use the demo available by Google TensorFlow or in the TensorFlow repository to try this out on my device. We can go over to that demo. And one of the things I've done, first off, I went in here to the on activity create and the camera to basics. And here I added my classifier. So this is image classifier cats versus dogs. And then inside of my new classifier, so I copied one of the classifiers that I already had there. I added the model path. So I put in my little TensorFlow model here. And then I put in some labels. And then I changed the size over here. So this, I haven't actually tried the new model. That's gonna be interesting. And then we have this little thing down here where they have actually taken each pixel value and fetched the mean of that pixel value. So they have rounded the pixel a bit and removed some noise, I guess. And for my case, it didn't work as well if I remove that kind of noise. So I just take the pixel values straight off so I get each channel into my image state. And that works better for this model because it's trained on real images, I guess. And then I keep the rest of the file intact. So this labels file, that could be interesting in looking at. So this is just cats and dogs and dummy. And in the model I created now, it's just cat and dog. So cat is 0 and dog is 1. So this is just to tell the model which labels should be used for each prediction in the output. So let's connect my device here and try some inference. So now you see here that I have actually a dog over here. So this is running an inference on a dog. Let's see if it can figure out that this is a dog. Yeah, it's turning around. It's turning around. And now it's pretty sure that this is a dog. So let's switch pages here and see, should this be a cat? Can it be a cat? It's not really sure yet. Do you see it? Yeah, it's turning around. And now it's pretty much sure that that's a cat. So you can see here, even though I didn't have that a well-trained model, it actually able to differentiate between cats and dogs, and with some certainty. It's not perfect, but it's at least something that you can start with and play around with your own model to check the difference between cat and dog. And this model I'm actually running now, it was before I actually retrained the model this afternoon. So that was a model I ran this morning, and it didn't have the dropout layer, and I actually got an error when I tried to convert that model into TensorFlow Lite. It said that there were some operations that was not supported, and when I tried to run it, I also got an error. So maybe it's not possible to actually run your models with a dropout layer, which I think is very sad, because dropout layers actually makes your model more robust. It might be something else that I put into the model that actually did that, but I think it was a dropout because that's the only new layer that I added. I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that you learned something today. If you have any questions about transforming your model back and forth or converting your model into TensorFlow Lite, please leave them in the comment section below. If you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you in the next video.